Inside of this beaker, we have a saturated solution of sodium chloride, better known as table salt, which has been dissolved into water. We are going to boil away this water, causing it to evaporate. But there are actually many ways that water can evaporate. Boiling, of course, is a common reason, but also the reduction of atmospheric pressure on the water will lower its boiling point, making this more attainable. Another reason is through the natural diffusion of molecules from the surface of the water into the atmosphere. We have sped up the boiling of this water in order to get to our reaction a bit sooner. However, what we expect to happen is that denser elements and molecules such as our sodium chloride will be left behind. This is how we get the formation of salt beds. As the water level drops, we begin to see depositions of crystal sodium chloride on the edge of the beaker. As the water reaches this point, this is far clearer to see. With a thick layer of salt on the outside of the glass, there is now no longer enough water for this salt to be dissolved within it. And eventually, all that we're left with is a salt bed, much like we see naturally occurring here on Earth, and even elsewhere in the solar system.